You know that feeling you get when it's just like a really gloomy day outside and you just don't feel like doing anything at all? That's how I feel right now, and I hate it and I wish it would go away. It is literally about to rain. It is so dark and gloomy outside. Hey dudes, what's up? Today I'm gonna be reading a few more of you guys' paranormal stories that you have sent me. It's October. I feel like this is like the perfect time to read a bunch of scary stories. So let's get into it. Also, I've noticed there's a lot of new people here, so welcome. Hi, hello. The first story I'm gonna read in this video comes from Michaela. And she says, "Hey girl, I just spam watched your paranormal stories and I have a sweet story to tell you. When I was a year old, my mom gave birth to my youngest sister. She unfortunately passed away 27 days after being born, but I was too young to meet her. I've always struggled with her passing more than anyone else in the family. I could never seem to move on from it and be okay with her passing. When I was about 16, I discovered I had a gift to help spirits find the light. Due to that, I have a shaman that I go to for clearings and healing. After my first appointment, my shaman proceeded to tell me that I have had my little sister's soul attached to mine for the last 15 years because she was lost and she needed someone to guide her. Whenever I was upset and crying, she would hug me and hold me together so I wouldn't fall apart." I just got like sweet chills, you know, like not like, oh my God, that is, I wanna cry, that's so sweet. "He removed her soul so I could move on. The rest of the day I was crying and felt more lost than I ever have, and more alone than I have ever felt. The next day, I was more accepting of her passing. Another story. I had this big mirror at my mom's house in my room, and my shaman told me it was a portal for spirits to come in and out of freely. When I moved out of her house, I brought it with me, like the idiot I am. Now I knew putting a blanket on top of mirrors acts as a block. So I was experiencing too much with the mirror in my new room, with no blanket on the mirror. Little things like voices and things would shift. I decided to move it out of my room and put a blanket over it. A friend came over a few months after moving it out, and she asked to see it. So I took her to the other room, closed the door, and lifted the blanket. The second the block wasn't active, I saw 10 orbs around the room, and they would follow me. I told her to put the blanket back over, and they disappeared. I left the room, and she stayed to try to take pictures. She didn't see anything herself, only I did. When she came back into my room, she told me this after the fact, and I was sitting on my bed looking at the door blanked out. And when she walked in, I snapped out of it and looked at her with evil eyes like I had evil intentions towards her. We're not friends anymore." Oh no. That's so funny that you guys aren't. I mean, it's not funny that you're not friends anymore, but like, it's kind of funny. You get it? Like, I'm not saying like, oh, it's funny you lost a friend, but like, it's kind of funny. Also, that mirror, I would definitely try to sage that mirror as much as you possibly can. Back to that first story that you shared, that is one of the sweetest things. I know that from my mom's friend that we have spiritual cords that you can't see, but it connects us to other people who we're really close to. I remember the first time, or one of the first times I spoke to my mom's friend, she told me that I had four cords, one connecting to my boyfriend, my cat Lilith, my sister, and my mom, I believe. The cords like basically act as like we like share energy with people, and sometimes that can be very draining and not very healthy for either party involved, because when there's the cord connected, you're able to share and kind of like take energy and give energy like to and from the other person, and it's not very healthy. So you need to cut those cords and like replace them with like positive energy and stuff. Cords and connections in that way, in the spiritual realm and plane, can be very harming to your energy and can drain you. Even if it is a positive connection between you and the other person, sometimes it can just be very harmful on yourself. So, interesting fact of the day. This next story comes from Maddie, and the reason I picked it is because she had an experience while watching one of my videos. So I'm like, did I cause it? Did I cause this to happen to you? And if I did, I'm so sorry. But anyways, on with her story. So she says, "Hey, I just watched your YouTube video on where you read paranormal experiences. I'm somewhat of a medium. I've been able to see and feel spiritual entities and other people's auras since I was a child. Here's one of my stories. My friend and I were watching one of your videos recently, and in the middle of you talking, my computer turned on. It was completely off, and the only way to turn it on is by clicking the mouse rapidly like a maniac, and obviously neither of us were doing that. My family was asleep, and the time was around 2 a.m. Anywho, my computer turned on and started opening tabs like Steam and Chrome, then exiting out of them. While this was going on, my bun, who has his cage next to my computer, starts frantically running in a circle, which was super weird considering he is a chill little dude who doesn't do that often. After a few seconds of this madness, it stopped. Did I do that? Did I do that? I'm sorry if I did that. But also, it opened up Steam. That's hilarious. It's like gaming time. So this next story comes from Sophia, and she says, "Hi, I just started watching your videos, and when I noticed you were sharing spooky stories, I was so glad. I want to share my story with you and your channel. I really hope you like it. So my name is Sophia, I'm from Chile, and this is like a series of paranormal things I've experienced when I was 12 and 13 years old. By that time, my little brother was 2 or 3 years old. He was recently learning how to talk and all that stuff. So that's one of the reasons why I really believe in this. He couldn't be lying. We lived in a really old house. That's reason number 2. And he had his own bedroom. One day, he told me and my mom he could see an old lady in his room. At first, we thought it was the neighbors, because we could see their house from his window. But another time, I asked him where he saw the lady. He told me he always saw her right next to the bed, and he actually showed me the spot inside of his room. That's some spooky shit. The second experience also involves my little brother. So that house had a very long hallway, and at the end of it was my mom's room. We always played in the hallway, some kind of game where I would chase him, he would run into my mom's room, come back, and then we would do that again. This happened at night, so all the lights were on. He ran into the room, and when he came back, he was so terrified, like he saw something in the room waiting for him. So he obviously came back crying and very scared. I picked him up really worried, asking what happened, and he was like, "The room. There's something," while crying. At first, I didn't know what to do, but then I followed the number one rule in horror movies. I went to the room to see what the hell was in there. Fortunately, I think, there was nothing, at least for me. It's clear he saw something that wasn't nice at all. Now, 10 years later, I'm sure he doesn't remember anything of that. We moved a few months after that, and he never experienced that kind of stuff again. Oh my goodness. Poor little dude. Again, I feel like this is a running theme of, like, stories that are shared on my channel. Kids see shit. This is the last story I'm gonna be reading in today's video, and it comes from Madison. Kind of funny, we had a Maddie earlier, and now we have a Madison. Hi, my name is Madison. I've got a couple paranormal stories to tell you. I had been living with my grandparents for a while, and we were living in a house that my grandfather was renovating, that his father had built years ago. He had also built the house in front, but we ended up smashing that house down to make room for new houses. As we smashed that house down, there were loud, distinctive screams and bangs of angry spirits that had been living there, as we forgot to say a prayer before we did it. Bad idea. As we renovated the house we had been living in, things started happening. I had been showering and I heard running up and down the hallway, as well as some slamming of sort. We didn't have carpet, so the flooring was all wooden, which made everything really loud. I instantly turned my shower off and sat down in the shower, scared out of my mind. Understandable, holy moly. I didn't know what to do. I finally got the courage to get out of the bathroom, and from there you can clearly see into the 2 bedrooms. Every single door and drawer was open in both bedrooms, which explains the slamming I heard of the drawers being mucked around in. I slept with my grandma that night, and at about 3 a.m. I woke up to my nan struggling to breathe. She was pinned down on the mattress, and whatever it was wouldn't let go of her. I was screaming for it to free her, and it didn't listen. It felt like a lifetime before she was freed. We didn't sleep for the rest of the night because we were both terrified. My granddad had fallen asleep on the couch and didn't wake up whatsoever throughout the whole night. We left the morning after to go out for breakfast, and as we reversed our car out of the driveway, we saw a man and a teenage boy standing at our kitchen window, laughing at us.
Biggie?
My nana screamed and told them to leave. We didn't see them at all after that. The family laughing at you? Why were they laughing at you? So that's all the stories I'm gonna be reading today. Thank you to everybody who has been sending me stories. I know that you guys hate sending it on Instagram because Instagram has like a cap for messages. So I went ahead and I made an email. You can find it down below, and then I'll also put it on the screen right here. If you guys wanna send me a story, please email me there. As always, I will leave all my other social media links in the description if you want to check out my Twitch, Twitter, or Instagram. But other than that, thank you guys so much for watching. I love you guys, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye, everybody.